We are well underway, but I think it's time we get to know the contestants a little bit better. Who has the most solo kills? Who has a hidden talent? And who has never left their city?
No, the right one.
Hey!
Hello?
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, we see you.
Wait a second and I'll...
Hello.
Hello.
Now it's perfect. My name is Carlos Rodriguez, and
I've been following you ever since League of Legends. You're the reason why I played so much mid lane.
That's so cool. I appreciate it.
My name is Karina. I'm head of communications at G2.
And I'm Lofar. I'm the G2 pro player for Hearthstone and now Fortnite.
I've been dreaming of competitive gaming since Halo 3. And now I'm here. I discovered Fortnite, and I'm constantly grinding Fortnite every day. My favorite Fortnite mechanic, building. I love the, it's like...
Lothar loves you
already. No, this is, I don't know if you, I'm pretty sure you actually made some research, because if you wouldn't have said that, you were out of the competition. Because this gentleman right here, he hates every single human being that can...
How you block, how you steal pyramids, how you steal floors so you can edit down and pump them fast. You have to play so quick before they can even react. They're like, what the hell just happened? That's why I love building.
And you're inspiring me. I just want to build right now. You gotta choose, because you said you want to be a competitor, but you also said you want to be an entertainer. Imagine there is a, at some point you have to make a decision.
It's very, very, very hard decision for me. Like, it's competitive, it has been my dream. I've always wanted to be on the stage, I've always wanted to compete, and I always wanted to have a family that I can compete with and lift each other up. But I've always wanted to entertain too.
There is no right answer.
My family is very, very supportive of me because they know this is what I want. You know, for my whole life, this is what I wanted to do. And they're finally happy that I'm taking the next step.
Perfect. Well, thanks so much, man. I appreciate your time. I appreciate your application.
So much. Bye, everyone.
He's so cute. He's so cute. So I gotta tell you, when you showed your bazookas on camera, I was slightly intimidated. Oh, the bazookas!
Right now I'm doing I'm trying to get a degree on a fitness coach.
So would you consider yourself a little bit of a variety player? Like you can play kind of multiple games at high level, you think?
When it's about shooters, I'm always above. I'm always on a pro level.
Okay.
Bye, guys.
Goodbye.
Thank you, bye.
Hello. Hello!
What time is it where we are right now?
It is almost 3 a.m.
We really like you, man. It is, like, your videos were hilarious. I was just laughing the whole time, you know? Really, really good.
Yeah, your clips made us laugh, like, a lot.
So, my man, what do you think makes you special?
It's not a focus of me, what I do. I try to make other people feel special. Although I like to be goofy and funny and all that stuff, it's because I like to see other people smile around me, because I think that other people just have great things that I want to bring out of them. But so many people are afraid to do that. So I'm glad to be that icebreaker, you know? Since I was young, I've been doing things like theater. I've been in, you know, a bunch of different choirs. I do a lot of things on stage and I speak way too much. I directed like musicals and theater productions at
local high school.
Yeah, it's fun. I like putting on a show, you know? And I like helping people, you know, find their passion.
So what's your favorite musical?
Right now, Dear Evan Hansen. It's currently on tour. Yeah.
I was actually there like a month ago. It was the second time I watched it. Before I die, I will direct and sing in my own musical. And there'll be three people there. It'll be Karina, Lothar, and maybe perhaps you.
Mwah.
Yeah.
Bye.
Oh, he's my favorite so far. Hello?
Hello.
Hi.
Hey,
how's it
going?
First game
with
can
the
you
camera,
hear me good?
And with the green screen and all, so we can put like fire and explosions behind you if you want to.
I'm a bit nervous, but excited at the same time.
By the way, what's going on with those white teeth? Like, what is going on? Do you live in a dentist?
I mean, I was born with my teeth, so I don't know. I guess you can blame my parents. I don't know.
Keep it as it is. We can just sell you to Colgate and get a sponsorship, you know?
Exactly.
Yeah, no, this is easy
sponsorship. Just toothbrush sponsorship. We got it done. What do you think makes you special?
special as a whole. I mean, I have pretty white teeth, so that's special.
Okay.
He's I guess it's a personality. I guess I'm positive. I'm a little bit crazy, a little bit stupid, you know. I think like if you're a positive person, you will attract more positive people to you, basically.
And that only applies to streaming, but applies to life in general.
Yeah. I was the biggest streamer in Slovenia, but that meant that I had like 130 people on my stream. Because I was watching TV and I casually look at my phone and I see G2 has tagged you in a photo and I was like, what? What is this? You know? I was like screaming. I was so happy. But of course, I told my parents, I told my friends, I told like my GF, I told everyone who matters, basically. So,
yeah. Do you call your girlfriend GF?
She was a bit nervous because she, like, there's a possibility that I have to move to Germany, so that's. That's why she was a bit nervous, yeah.
It's me or G2. Well, baby, I don't know.
I mean, GF or G2. Both start with a G, but...
We really love you. We think you're great. And make sure you brush your teeth at least 7 times before each video.
Okay. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much, guys. Cheers. Bye.
Yay! Yeah, when I was a kid, like, well, I've always been like a gamer, so like, even if it was Xbox, PS4, or whatever. So for Christmas, my father had bought me this gaming system. And I mean, it's broken now, like I can't play it now, but I used to play it like every day from like 9 to like 11 years old. I've been competing in Call of Duty up until I was probably my freshman year of college. So that kind of shaped me as a competitive person in everything.
What were you studying? You graduated now, right?
I graduated from Stony Brook University with a degree in occupational therapy and health sciences with a disabilities concentration because my sister has autism and my mother works with children with autism. So I've always been interested in working with people with disabilities. So that's why I got my degree in concentration in that. Like I said, I've always been surrounded by gaming, but it's kind of never really dawned on me that this could be a career or this could be something I can do for the rest of my life. So with that kind of, with this opportunity at least, I wanted to take it full on head and I wanted to make this something that, like, I want to kind of make my dream come true.